business. You know what is the most influencing thing I like about businesses around the world? Their hunger to reach more and more people. And it's a good thing, because the much larger is the audience, so big will be the impact created. And because of this ability to create a huge impact, the entire world is blaming businesses for their unethical environmental policies which create a huge impact on the environment. Thus, on today's time, everyone is putting a constant pressure on them to become responsible and sustainable. But you know what? Businesses are becoming more sustainable. Don't you see the eco-friendly packaging, eco-friendly apparels, eco-friendly plastic, energy and whatnot? Seems like businesses are taking steps to become more sustainable, right? But are they actually doing it? Or simply putting up a facade of sustainability while continue to engage in activities that cause more waste and more greenhouse gases? This is exactly what greenwashing is. Greenwashing is essentially when a company or organization spends more time and money on marketing themselves as being sustainable than on actually minimizing their environmental impact. But why do companies do that? It's simple. Being seen as ethical drives profitability. As people around the world are becoming more aware of the importance of their daily choices, it's a deceitful advertising method to gain favor with those consumers. Unfortunately, there are many examples of organizations engaging in greenwashing. In 2018, Nestle released a statement saying that it had ambitions for its packaging to be 100% recyclable or reusable by 2025. However, environmental groups were quick to point out that the company hadn't released clear targets or a timeline to accompany its ambitions. Greenpeace reacted to this by releasing its own statement, in which it said, "Nestle's statement on plastic packaging includes more of the same greenwashing baby steps to tackle a crisis it helped to create, and sets an incredibly low standard as the largest food and beverage company in the world." Another example is the fast fashion brand H&M. H&M was under investigation for its supposedly ethical, conscious collection. H&M and other fast fashion retailers are renowned for exploiting the vagueness of green terminology to appear more environmentally conscious and sell more clothes. This is a problem, because fast fashion is one of the biggest polluters on the planet. In 2020 alone, an estimated 18 million tons of clothing ended up in landfill. So the important question arises that how can you spot that a brand is greenwashing? Well, there are a number of ways you can spot it. Brands generally use fluffy language, that is, the words or terms with no clear meaning. Example, eco-friendly, produced sustainably, while providing no proof of a claim. Also, if a brand is greenwashing, it will emphasize one tiny green attribute while everything else will be dirty. Take an example of BP. It's a fossil fuel giant. The company placed solar panels on its gas stations and said that it's working to be more sustainable. As we are moving towards the end of this video, there's an important thing we should recognize. We have immense power as consumers. We create the landscape that businesses operate in. So, where our money goes, their focus goes. We need to make sure that their focus goes towards sustainability. Businesses cannot get away with greenwashing anymore. As the climate crisis accelerates, we simply can't waste any time in shifting to more eco-friendly practices.